All right, my friends. How are you? Bernard again from Binary Winners Club. Today I have a special video for you. And this special video is a reaction to many requests I've received from members in the academy, members in the bigger Binary Winners Club, that, hey, Bernard, give us a system, give us some trading system that can help us at least be able to trade profitably without too much guesswork, without too much ambiguity. Members are giving honest comments saying that they learn too many things, and when facing the market, they just don't know what to do. They see price moving up and down and they're confused. And I decided, fine, I'm going to work on a system that could help you at least reduce some of those emotions, give you objective setups, objective signals. Signals that if I give 100 of you, majority of you would be able to see the same signal and would be able to trade it the same way and most likely get similar results. So welcome. And before I proceed, smash that subscribe button. Why are you not subscribed? Hey, please subscribe and make sure that at the end of the video, give your comment. Tell me what you'd like me to do next for you, a video, what you want me to talk about, topics, maybe reviews you would want me to do. I'm here for you. So we dig in and talk about objective trading system number one. Now, when I talk about objective trading system here, I'm talking about a trading system that is based on rules, strict rules. And you understand, without proper rules, we are not able to trade the market properly. Without proper rules, we can't trade the markets properly and we will not have consistent results. So that's why I'm talking about strict rules here, okay? The strict rules you follow for this particular trading system would help eliminate guesswork, would also therefore help you avoid working or trading under the influence of your emotions, okay? So this particular trading system is really a very simple one, and I would like you to engage with it and see how it fares for you. There are four components to this trading system. Number one, there's a component of following the trend. Number two, we are trading from key levels. Number three, there is a signal and some confirmation of that signal. Once you have rule number one, rule number two, rule number three, and even four, place a trade. Then wait for the results. Okay, so let's move on and see what this system is about, or what does it look like anyway. Number one, we move to, this is the chart. Forget about these writings here. The templates I give you for this objective trading system number one has only two indicators. Interesting. Number one, the most important down here, FXBO objective trading system number one. This is the most important part of this, followed by these lines here, which give you support and resistance. This one is just, you know, a timer for you to know whether it's the appropriate time to place a trade or not. Those are the indicators. So number one and number two, this one is a constant. Almost in every chart you are trading, you need time. So it's not an indicator as such. So two indicators, non-repaint, if you understand how they work, non-repaint, this one is purely non-repaint. This one is based on the concept of higher highs, higher lows. Once you have three dots, it means that line is permanently fixed on the chart. Once you have three, the first three green dots means that support is confirmed and will never repaint. Once you have the first three red dots, that resistance is confirmed and will never repaint. So it's not repainting. Automatic SNR, these lines are there. They are part of the package you get. They are part of the template. Clean charts, as I told you, only one indicator here and another one here. It's a clean chart. We don't have too many things here. Then we have, it's a profitable trading system. As you can see, if you follow the rules, you're patient to look for the correct setups, you will stay around 75 to 85% accurate, depending on market conditions. Of course, you don't start trading when there's news. You don't start trading when markets are so quiet or when markets are very volatile. In normal trading markets, when you observe those rules, when you see nice candles like this, the market will be able to give you proper results. And of course, this reduces emotions because, like I've told you, you are not going to start thinking in terms of, is this the correct level? Did I draw it properly? Is it supposed to be here or here? Or is it here or is it here? You are confused when you are facing a live market. You know, candles are creating on the chart and you're asking, this is the correct level, trend, etc. That's not there. Your focus is read this indicator, read this, read the candle coming to the level and decide based on the rules I'm going to share briefly. So friends, easy, easy, easy. Now, let's see what we need to do. What do we need to do? We want to describe each of these indicators and how to use them. Number one, trend power. So the indicator down here, the objective trading system indicator, number one down here, is used to gauge the power of buyers and sellers in terms of can buyers continue the trend? Can buyers reverse the, can sellers continue the trend? If buyers are strong, we go with buyers. And if buyers are weak, we go with sellers. Okay. So the green histogram, when the green histogram is bigger than the red histogram, is an indication that buyers are strong. When the red histogram is bigger than the green histogram, it means sellers are stronger than buyers. And that's how you interpret it. Okay. So let's move from that to trading levels. The trading levels we have here are what you are seeing. And they are, this is your resistance, the red dots, and this is your support. Okay, the green dots. As I said earlier, once you have three of them, that support level is confirmed. Once you have three of them here, that resistance is confirmed and the lines will never change again. So that's number two. So you have the trend power. You have the trend power here. You have the support resistance. The next thing is, how do we take a signal then? Now we are going to trade on the concept of breakout with pullbacks or bounce from support and resistance levels. So pullbacks or bounce from support and resistance levels. So I'll show you some setups that will help you understand the concept behind what we are trading here. Now pay attention here. Number one, market broke supports, the green dots with this candle. It's a breakout candle. At least market stayed below one candle, two candle, second candle, that's two candles are below the level. Market pulls back to this level that was broken with this candle. But on this candle, sellers down here are outweighing. They are stronger than buyers. You take a sell trade for 3 to 5 candles, but you have to be consistent. You take either 5 candles only or 3 candles only. This M1 charts, 1 minute. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there you are. You get your winning trade over there. This is a sell trade. Now let's look at another sell signal. We have a breakout of support here by this big candle. Market stays below this level for some candles, then pulls back to that level, tries to break the same level now once again, but who is strong? We are breaking resistance. At resistance, we expect sellers, and indeed sellers are confirmed as strong. So 1, 2, 3, you win here, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you win down there. Okay, so that's the logic. That's the logic. Breakout and pull back to the breakout level, or simply market at support and the buyers are strong, or the market at resistance and sellers are strong. Those are the only two signals you take from this. So let's see buy signals. Here we go. Now with buy signals, so what do we have in mind? In buy signals, as you can see, market was actually trying to do this, up, down, up, down, up, down, right? So market is in an uptrend in short, but I told you, don't worry about that. This guy will take care of that stuff. So market has broken support. You can see those green dots. Market has broken support by this candle, okay? And buyers immediately are strong. We are breaking support, buyers are strong, only green. It's a red candle, but buyers are still strong in this trend. So 1, 2, 3, you win. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you win. Same buy signal here. We break this support area. If you look down here, green part of the histogram is longer than the red one. You take 1, 2, 3, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There you go. So you're asking Bernard, why are the other signals not taken? Okay, let's work with you together on this. We come to support area. We break this support area. Buyers are strong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you're winning. All right. We are breaking resistance, but buyers are strong. So no signal there. And then we are here. We are coming to support area. So this is a resistance that was broken. Market's coming back, but we're strong. Sellers. No, don't trade in that area. We are trading pullbacks to continue, not to do the reversal. Okay. So here we are breaking resistance. But if you check what's happening down here, buyers are strong. So don't, we are trying to reverse. After we break a level, we are trying to reverse and continue in the direction of the stronger player. Okay. So here we are trying to break resistance. And as we break resistance, it's buyers who are strong. What I want is at resistance, I want to see sellers are strong so that I can sell. At support, I want to see buyers are strong so that I can buy. I'm not doing anything opposite. Okay, so at resistance, if market has broken a level like this and is coming back, okay, I want to see buyers are strong so that I can buy here. If the market was going down, all right, and we have a level here, I want to see that sellers are strong here so that I can sell. I don't want to buy. So that's the logic behind this. So on the previous charts where we had sell signals, let's see whether we had other signals. Of course, I was not looking at everything. I wanted to show you a little bit of what we need to do. Here, we are breaking support. So I'm looking to buy, but I see that sellers are stronger than buyers. So I'm not interested in buying. Here, we are breaking resistance. I expect sellers to be strong. Then I will sell. But here, buyers are strong instead. So I'm not doing anything, right? So again, here, we are breaking resistance. I expect sellers to be strong at resistance. They are not strong, so I'm not placing a trade. Same thing, we are breaking this level, okay? We are breaking this level. I expect sellers to be strong, but buyers are strong instead, no trade, okay? Same thing here, breakout, retracement, but again, it appears buyers are strong, so I'm not trading there. Now, in the second round of this video, I will show you how to trade the opposite side. For example, if this is breaking of resistance, buyers are strong, we can go up. Okay. If we break support, sellers are strong, we can go down. If we are breaking support, sellers are strong, we can go down. We are breaking support, buyers are strong instead. Okay. But there's no rejection. I told you there's a filter. If there's no strong rejection, you don't take a trade. Of course, if you took a trade here based on this concept, you would lose that trade. Nothing is 100%. There's an explanation for this, and I'll share some of those tips in a later video. Okay, guys, so I will take you to the chart and we scroll together and see some of the setups that one could consider taking. This is my GBP USD. I can scroll back to an earlier date, maybe here and stop. This is the London market shaded in red. So I'll try to see whether I can get some 1, 2, 3 setups, and there we go. We break support. We pull back, we break support here. As we break support, who is strong here? Buyers. Green is bigger than red. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you're winning. Okay. That's a winning trade. I told you at support, I want to buy, at resistance, I want to sell. So once we break this level, we stay below by at least 1 or 2 candles. If we come back, this level would be resistance. Okay. So here I'm not using it. Again, we break support. Buyers are strong. You see? Green is bigger than red. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're winning over there, right? That's another winning trade. And then now we are going to resistance. We are trying to break resistance, but buyers are strong. At resistance, I want sellers to be strong for my trade. All right, so no trade there. We are breaking support once again here. Who is strong here, guys? Buyers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We are up there. Okay. So that's how I'm trading this. We are breaking support here. We're breaking support with a very long candle. Buyers are strong. This is a case where you lose. There's an explanation for that. I don't want to go into that for now. All right. So here is another case. you're breaking support. Buyers are strong. If your eyes can be properly used in this, you can see. Or if you can't see, just avoid. Okay. If you can't see the size, avoid. Here we break this level. Again, I can see buyers are off straight, stronger than sellers. We go up. Now, after we have broken this level can be used as resistance. We break it, but buyers are strong, not a trade. We are at resistance. Buyers are strong. We are not trading. At resistance, I want to sell. At support, I want to buy. Remember. So now we are moving on. We are at resistance again. Sellers are strong. See that? Red is bigger than green. So we go in 5 candles. All right? Then we go. At support, we are breaking support. This candle has broken below this level. We have buyers being strong here. We are going up instead. So guys, that's how we are using this. Pretty straightforward. Follow that logic and you will be profitable. Thank you for watching this video and do remember to subscribe to my channel, Binary Winners Club. Remember to come to Telegram as well, okay? Come to Telegram and find us there. It's also Binary Winners Club. You'll find us on Telegram. So you're asking Bernard, this piece of trading tool, what do you sell it at? I'm not really selling it at anything, but I want to help as many people as possible for those who care, okay? For the effort put into crafting some of these and defining the rules. Members of Binary Winners Club Academy, BWC Academy, are allowed to pay $50 to get a copy. This is MT4, it's based on MT4. And members of the larger Binary Winners Club who are not in the Academy can pay $75. If you are not in any of these two categories, then you will pay $100. The payment can be through Skrill, PayPal, you can use Neteller, you can use Web Money or Perfect Money. Those are the options available. Do remember to stay subscribed for more videos like this. I'll be launching another one in about 2-3 days. And I'll be adding more content to YouTube so that you can benefit. In case you need me to discuss something educational or in one of the videos, comment below and tell me what you want me to talk about. In case you want me to talk about more of these objective trading systems, let me know. Your comments will allow me to know what is important for you, my audience, and my fellow traders. Bye-bye for now. See you in the next video.